Hello and welcome to bankersadda.com. This is the session for English language. Today we are going to discuss the English quiz for IBPS exams 2019. Today, this is the day 26 of the 6 month preparation plan for IBPS exams 2019. And the topic for today's quiz is close test. This is the new pattern close test. जो आपका IBPS PO mains और clerk mains में आया था. Let's start with the first question. Directions 1 to 10. Read the following passage and attempt the questions as directed. अब आपको हर question के लिए अलग-अलग direction दिया है. उसके according आपको करना है. Let's see the first. Which of the following words given in the options should come at the place marked as A in the above paragraph to make it grammatically correct and meaningful? Also, the word should fill in the blanks given in the two sentences given below to make them contextually correct and meaningful. Passage में आपको एक blank दिया है A. यहाँ पर ऐसा word fit करना है जो इन दोनों blanks में भी आए. यानी किसका question हो गया आपका triple fillers का. Let's see. The picture of the victim's body are sure to dash feelings of anger within the jury. तो exciting feelings नहीं होगा. Provoke हो सकता है. इंस्पायरिंग नहीं होगा. मोटिवेशन फीलिंग्स नहीं होगा. मोटिवे टू के साथ आपका फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ वर्ब आएगा. तो आपका आंसर क्या होना चाहिए? प्रोवोक. अब देखते हैं प्रोवोक बाकी में जा रहा है. नोबडी एक्सपेक्टेड द टीन्स डेथ टू प्रोवोक अ नेशनल इन्वेस्टिगेशन इनटू द ब्रूटलिटी ऑफ पुलिस फोर्स. ये भी जा रहा है. और क्वेश्चन में As India mourns the death of 40 CRPF personnel in Thursday's terrorist strike in Jammu and Kashmir's Pulwama district, it is clear that the attack was meant to provoke. Provoke ka meaning aapka kya hai? Stimulate or give rise to a reaction or emotion or a strong feeling. ठीक है, तो provoke यहाँ पर आपका तीनों statements में fit हो रहा है. That means B will be the answer. Question 2. Which of the following phrases should fill in the blank in B to make it contextually correct and meaningful? In phrases में से कौन सा grammatically और contextually B में fit होगा? The Jaish-e-Mohammed, the Pakistan-based terrorist organization which has orchestrated numerous strikes in the Kashmir Valley, has taken responsibility dash in any attack in the state. Has taken responsibility for what is now the highest toll of security forces. If you see, ये आपका बिल्कुल correct है. For what now the highest, ये आपका grammatically ठीक नहीं है. For what have now the highest toll of security force, ये भी incorrect है. For what is now the highest, highly toll of security, नहीं. Highest toll of security forces. तो आपका A जो है, correct हो जाएगा. Question 3. एक sentence दिया है आपको. In a passage, a sentence C is given in bold. There may or may not be an error in one part of the sentence. Choose the part which has an error in it as your answer. If there is no error, then choose option E as your answer. आपको error वाला part बताना है. There is no question that Pakistan bears the onus to explaining why Masood Azhar, the leader of the Jaish-e-Mohammed, enjoys such freedoms on its territory, if not outright support from the establishment. अगर आप देखें, two के साथ आपका ing form incorrect है, तो आपका error जो है part A में आ जाएगा, खत्म. Question 4. The sentence given in D has four words given in bold. Among the bold words, which of the following must replace each other to make the sentence contextually correct and meaningful? अब आपको बताना है कौन सा रिप्लेस करेगा. Let's see. Early details indicate that a sports utility vehicle laden with a huge quantity of explosives targeted the convoy of 78 buses carrying about 2500 soldiers from Jammu to Kashmir. तो इफ यू सी इसमें आपका Early details indicate, okay, that a sports utility vehicle laden with a huge quantity of explosive targeted the convoy of 78 buses carrying about 2500 soldiers from Jammu to Kashmir. So, ye theek hai, isme koi change ki zarurat nahi hai. Theek hai? No changes required. Next. A word is given in bold in E. Choose the word which should replace the word given in bold to make the sentence correct and meaningful. If no change is required, choose option E as your answer. फिर से देखते हैं, कोई word आपका E को replace कर सकता है कि नहीं? The video of the presumed suicide bomber two hints at an altered standard operating procedure meant to provoke and escalate tensions. अगर आपका provoke है, मतलब अराइज करना नेगेटिव फीलिंग्स, तो ये एंड के बाद भी सिमिलर आना चाहिए, तो एस्केलेट यहाँ करेक्ट है. अब एस्केलेट की जगह श्रिंक नहीं आएगा, प्लंजिंग नहीं आएगा, ग्रोथ नहीं आएगा. ग्रोइंग होता तो आ सकता था, सप्रेसिंग नहीं आएगा, तो आपका यहाँ पर कोई चेंज नहीं हो सकता. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, बिफोर मूविंग फर्दर, आपको पता है कि SBI PO का नोटिफिकेशन वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट इन मार्च और अप्रैल. सो इट्स बेटर to start preparing from now then just waiting for the notification and then start preparing. So agar aapko SBI PO prelims PO 2019 crack karna hai, to you should start preparing from right on. Iske liye aapko ek test series hai, SBI PO prime 2019. You get the same online interface jo aapka exams mein aata hai, उसी इंटरफेस में आप प्रैक्टिस कर पाएंगे, तो आपकी स्पीड भी इम्प्रूव होगी और एक्यूरेसी भी इम्प्रूव होगी. अलॉन्ग विद द क्वेश्चंस यू विल गेट वीडियो सॉल्यूशंस, जिसमें आपको थरो एनालिसिस मिलेगा हर एक क्वेश्चन का और डिटेल्ड एक्सप्लेनेशंस मिलेंगी. सो डू मेक द बेस्ट ऑफ दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी. नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. फिर से आपका ट्रिपल फिलर का क्वेश्चन है, देखते हैं आप. इन ऑर्डर टू सेंड अ मैसेज टू द ब्रेन, द डैश बिटवीन द सेंसेस एंड द ब्रेन कैन बी अकम्प्लिश्ड इफ द मैसेज इज सेंड स्ट्रेट टू द ब्रेन टू इंटरसेप्ट. तो द डैश बिटवीन, इंस्टीट्यूट बिटवीन नहीं होगा, इम्बैलेंस्ड बिटवीन पास्ट नहीं होगा, कोऑर्डिनेशन. कोऑर्डिनेशन क्या होता है? ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑफ द डिफरेंट एलिमेंट्स ऑफ अ कॉम्प्लेक्स बॉडी या एक्टिविटी, जिससे कि वो एक साथ मिलकर काम कर सके, तो कोऑर्डिनेशन होगा. एजिटेट नहीं होगा, कोऑर्डिनेशन यहाँ फिट हो रहा है. नेक्स्ट देखते हैं, द डांस नीड्स क्लोज कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन टू डांसर्स. तो आपका यहाँ तो फिट हो रहा है, एक बार ब्लैंक में देखते हैं. एफ फोरेंसिक्स टीम हैव ऑलरेडी बिगन वर्क एंड आंसर्स टू द disturbing questions the attack has raised on intelligence gathering, dissemination and coordination in the valley must be pieced together. तो coordination कहाँ पर? valley में. ठीक है, बिल्कुल आपका answer हो गया option C. moving on to the next question. अब आपका यहाँ G में एक phrase आना है, कौन सा आएगा देखते हैं. फ्रेज फिल करना है जो ग्रामेटिकली और कंटेक्चुअली यहाँ करेक्ट हो. हाउएवर इफ द टेररिस्ट हैव एक्टेड फ्रॉम एन अपडेटेड प्लेबुक, न्यू दिल्ली'ज रिस्पांस मस्ट नॉट प्ले विद देयर प्लान, प्ले इनटू देयर प्लान्स विद रिफ्लेक्सिव एंड प्रेसिपिटेट ऑफिशियल एक्शन. इंडिया हैज विथड्रॉन द मोस्ट फेवर्ड नेशन स्टेटस टू पाकिस्तान इन अ सिग्नल दैट इट विल नॉट वेट फॉर प्रिलिमिनरीज इन द एफर्ट टू आइसोलेशन पाकिस्तान, नो. In the effort to isolating Pakistan, no. In the effort for isolate Pakistan, ये भी incorrect है. In the effort to isolate Pakistan, ये यहाँ correct है. अब यहाँ पर कई बारी in an effort to होता है, but यहाँ पर आपका एक specific effort की बात हो रही है, कौन सा? To isolate Pakistan. तो हम यहाँ in the effort use करेंगे. Next question 8. एट में आपको क्या है? एच में बोल्ड सेंटेंस है, इसमें कोई एरर है तो बताना है. कोएर्सिव डिप्लोमेसी इज लाइकली टू कंटिन्यू बट टू बी इफेक्टिव द एफर्ट नीड्स अ वाइडर नेट स्पेशली एट अ टाइम व्हेन द यूएस इज सीकिंग पाकिस्तान्स हेल्प इन फर्मिंग अप अ डील विद द अफगान तालिबान. अगर आप देखें तो इसमें कोई भी एरर नहीं है, ऑल सेंटेंसेज आर करेक्ट. तो आपका आंसर हो जाएगा ई, नो एरर. Question 9. नाइन में अब आपका वर्ड रिप्लेसमेंट का क्वेश्चन है. सेंटेंस में चार वर्ड्स है, बीजिंग टू मस्ट नॉट एंड कैन नॉट इवेड, क्वेश्चंस अबाउट इट्स प्रीवियस ब्लॉकिंग ऑफ एक्शन एट द यूएन स्पेसिफिकली अगेंस्ट अजर. तो अगर आप इसमें देखें सारे के सारे वर्ड्स बिल्कुल करेक्ट लगे, अगर आप इनको इंटरचेंज करेंगे तो कुछ भी मीनिंगफुल नहीं बनेगा, तो आपका आंसर ई ऑप्शन हो जाएगा. क्वेश्चन 10, अ वर्ड इज गिवन इन बोल्ड इन जे, सब्सटैंटिव दिया है आपको, चूज द वर्ड विच शुड रिप्लेस द वर्ड गिवन इन बोल्ड विदाउट चेंजिंग द मीनिंग ऑफ द सेंटेंस. अब आपको बताना है कोई वैसा वर्ड है जो इस सेंटेंस इसका सिनोनिम हो. सब्सटैंटिव का मीनिंग क्या होता है, हैविंग अ फर्म बेसिस इन रियलिटी एंड सो इम्पॉर्टेंट मीनिंगफुल और कंसिडरेबल. ठीक है, कुछ बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट या कंसिडरेबल हो, तो यहाँ एक ये एडजेटिव है सब्सटैंटिव एक्शन, कंसिडरेबल एक्शन, तो कंसिडर्ड तो नहीं होगा, सैबोटेज नहीं होगा, अनफ्रूटफुल, बिविल्डर, ये सब इससे रिलेटेड नहीं है, तो आपका आंसर यहाँ होगा नो चेंज पॉसिबल. नाउ वी हैव अ डिफरेंट पैसेज हियर. अब इसके क्वेश्चंस देखते हैं, अगेन ट्रिपल फिलर. क्वेश्चन 11, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वर्ड्स गिवन इन ऑप्शन शुड कम एट प्लेस एट ए, और जो इन दोनों में भी फिल होना चाहिए. देखते हैं, एयरलाइंस रिपोर्टेडली आर क्रैकिंग डाउन ऑन दिस डिक्लाइनिंग बट इलीगल ट्रेड. बट है तो यानी कुछ कॉन्ट्रोडिक्टरी आना चाहिए यहाँ पर, कंट्रास्टिंग. द वंस डैश डाउन टाउन हैज फॉलन इनटू स्टीप डिक्लाइन सिंस द न्यू मॉल वॉज बिल्ट. वंस क्या था, अब वो फॉल हो गया है, तो यानी वो कुछ पॉजिटिव रहा होगा, तो डिक्लाइनिंग तो हट गया, लैंग्वेज हट गया, अनहेल्दी भी हट गया, इनफर्म भी यहाँ हट गया, थ्राइविंग जो है वो आपका यहाँ पॉजिटिव सेंस में आएगा, थ्राइविंग मतलब फ्लरिशिंग और ग्रोइंग, तो ये आपका पॉजिटिव सेंस में इन दोनों स्टेटमेंट्स में परफेक्टली फिट हो रहा है. लेट्स सी इन द ब्लैंक, द डेथ ऑफ मोर देन 100 पीपल टू टॉक्सिक एल्कोहल इन उत्तर प्रदेश एंड उत्तराखंड हैज एक्सपोज्ड द थ्राइविंग सेल ऑफ इलिसिट लिकर इन द रीजन. तो थ्राइविंग सेल यानी जो फ्लरिश कर रही थी सेल, दिस इज करेक्ट. क्वेश्चन 12, अगेन बी में अब आपको फ्रेज फिल करना है. इंडिया रिमेन्स अमंग द कंट्रीज विद अ हाई नंबर ऑफ एल्कोहल रिलेटेड डेथ्स विद पुअर गवर्नेंस करप्शन एंड डिस्टॉर्टेड पॉलिसीज कंट्रीब्यूट टू सच पीरियोडिक ट्रेजेडीज. कंट्रीब्यूशन टू सच पीरियोडिक ट्रेजेडीज कंट्रीब्यूटिंग टू, ये वाला इनकरेक्ट हो गया. अब यहां पे क्या होगा, कंट्रीब्यूटिंग टू सच पीरियोडिक ट्रेजेडीज, तो आपका आंसर कौन सा हो जाएगा, डी, कंट्रीब्यूटिंग टू सच पीरियोडिक ट्रेजेडीज, ऑप्शन डी. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इन द पैसेज गिवन अ सेंटेंस सी इज गिवन इन बोल्ड, देयर मे और मे नॉट बी एन एरर इन वन पार्ट ऑफ द सेंटेंस, चूज द पार्ट विच हैज एन एरर इन इट एज योर आंसर, इफ देयर इज नो एरर देन चूज ऑप्शन ई एज योर आंसर. एरर बताना है. प्रिलिमिनरी इन्वेस्टिगेशन हैज कन्फर्म्ड द वेल एंट्रेंच्ड सिस्टम of illicit liquor vents that are known to exist in the region. Several factories producing hooch in UP were unearthed within a couple of days in the episode. So, agar aap dekhe, it is within a couple of days of the episode. They should be off and not in. So, error will be in part D. Next question. Ab aapko again स्टेटमेंट दिया है डी में, उसमें फोर वर्ड्स बोल्ड में हैं, को बताना है कि कौन सा यहाँ पर इंटरचेंज हो सकता है. मोर ओवर ऑल्दो सेवरल लिकर रिलेटेड डेथ्स हैव बीन टेकिंग प्लेस, ठीक है, इट टुक दिस इलिसिट नंबर ऑफ कैजुअलिटीज फॉर द अथॉरिटीज टू एक्नॉलेज द प्रेजेंस ऑफ फ्री फ्लोइंग स्टैगरिंग लिकर. यहाँ स्टैगरिंग लिकर नहीं आएगा, स्टैगरिंग नंबर और इलिसिट लिकर, तो स्टैगरिंग और इलिसिट यहाँ पर चेंज होना चाहिए. कहां पर है आपका, हमारा ये ऑप्शन में, ये ऑप्शन सी में. लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर द डे, इट्स अगेन word replacement. A word is given in E, choose the word which should replace the word given in bold without changing the meaning, yani synonym. Ab dekhte hain. It has tried to put the blame for previous incidents on political opponents hatching conspiracies. So blame kya hota hai, exam lagana ya responsibility. So benefit to nahi hoga, accountability hoga. Applause bhi nahi ho sakta, exculpation bhi nahi aur commendation bhi nahi. It should be accountability ya responsibility. That means your correct answer choice will be B. Okay, so that's all for today's session. Thank you and have a nice day.
Good morning, friends. Today we are going to discuss quantitative aptitude quiz based on regular DI for IBPS. Okay, so today day 26 for CAR IBPS 2018 FATEH. Okay, so the topic is regular DI. So here question will be based on regular DI. Now we move on questions. In the first section, directions from 1 to 5 is given as the following table shows total number of selected participants and percentage distribution of those selected participants of a city in all the 5 years. Study the table carefully to answer the related questions. Okay, so these are the years and these are the different cities, and in different cities total number of participants and percentage of participants is also given. Now we will see the question. The first question: how many participants are selected in DID in 2007 from all the cities together? So here total in Delhi 450. So required answer, direct we can say required answer will be in 2007. So 24%, that is 24/100 into 450 plus in Delhi, in Mumbai, in Lucknow, Vadodara and Bhopal. So in Mumbai this will be 20%, that is 20/100 into 750 plus 15%, so 15/100 into 480 plus 15% again, so 15/100 into 640 plus 5%, so 5/100 into 360. Okay, now if we solve this, this will be 0 and 9, and this is 2, so this is 12, this is 0 cancel. Okay, this is 0, this is 2, this is 3, again this is 24, 0 cancel, 2, this is 3, and this will be 3 2. Okay, now 0 cancel, this is 2, so this is 1 8. Okay, now 12 into 9, 108 plus this will be 75 into 2, that is 150. This will be 3 into 24, this is 72. This is 32 into 3, 96, and this is 18. If we add these all, we will find 444. This is the required answer. And if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number second. In the second question, question. In the second question, number of participants selected from Mumbai in the year 2006 is what percent more or less than that of Vadodara in the same year? So in Mumbai in 2006, so this is 2006, in Mumbai 16% and in Vadodara 20%. So number of selected participant from Mumbai these are 16%, 16 upon 100 into 750, this will be 2 and this is 15, this is 8, so this is 120 and from Vadodara, this is 20%, 20 upon 100 into 640, so this will be 128. Okay, so the required percentage will be 128 minus 120 divided by 128 into 100. Here number of selected participants from Vadodara are more than number of selected participants from Mumbai. So in percentage this will be more, so here this is 8 by 128 into 100, so this is 2, 4 is common, so 3, 2, okay, again this is 1, 6, so 100 by 16, so 100 by 16, this will be, here 4 is common, so 24 by 4, so this is 6.25% more. Okay, so the required answer is 6.25% more, and if you look at options, B will be the right option. Here in the question, number of participants selected from Mumbai in what percent more or less, so this will be less because number of participants from Vadodara is more than number of participants from Mumbai, so this will be C, 6.25% less. Okay, now we move on next question. Question number third. In the third question, what is the average number of participants in the year 2008 from all the cities together who get selected in DID? Approximate value is asking. Average number of participants in 2008 from all the cities together. So this is 2008 and these are the percentage of participants who got selection in DID. Okay, so the required average will be total cities are 5, so 1 upon 5, in Delhi 16%, so 1 6 upon 100 into 450 plus 24%, that is 24 upon 100 into 750 plus 20%, so 20 upon 100 into 480 in Lucknow, okay. And in Vadodara 10%, so 10 upon 100 into 640 plus 25 upon 100 into 360. Okay, so here 1 upon 5, this is 00, this is 9, this is 2, this is 8, so this is 72, and this is 0, 2, 15, and this will be 12. So 12 into 15 will be 180 plus this will be 480 into 2, that is 96, and this is 64, and this is 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 into 360, that is 90. Okay, if you solve this, 72 plus 180 plus 96 plus 64 plus 90, if we add these all, the value will be 502 divided by 5, or approximately we can see that this will be 100. Okay, so the required average will be 100, and we, if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number fourth. In the fourth question, what is the ratio of participants selected from Lucknow in 2019 and 10 together to those who were selected from Bhopal in the years 2009 and 10 together? Okay, so Lucknow, in Lucknow 2009 and 10 mein jo participants select hue unka ratio Bhopal mein se 2009 and 10 mein select hue unse ratio kitna hoga? So 2009 and 10 in Lucknow percentage 25%, 30%, and in Bhopal 30% and 25%. So required ratio will be, required ratio as given in table, 25 30, so this will be 55%. So 55 into 480, okay, divided by, this is also 55. So 55 into 360, okay, 55 55 cancel, 00 cancel, 48 upon 36, so this will be 4/3. Okay, 12 is common in both, so 4:3 will be the required ratio, and if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number fifth. In the fifth question, if in 2005 the number of selected participants from Delhi and Mumbai were 20% and 40% less than that of 2006 respectively, then find the difference between selected participants of Delhi and Mumbai in year 2005. So in 2005, selected participants, or we can say required difference, direct required difference in Delhi and Mumbai. So in Delhi 20% less than that in 2006. So in 2006 this is 20%. So 20% less means 80% of 20% of 450. Okay, this is a sign of difference. We will take mod value of this, or we can say this is minus mod value. Okay, and in Mumbai 40% less, so in Mumbai this is 16%. 40% less means 60% of 16% of 750. Okay, if we solve this, here 00 cancel, this is 8 into 2 16, so this will be, and this is 10 also cancel, so this will be 16 into 4 5 divided by 10 minus, this is 6 into 16 into 7 5 divided by 100. Okay, this will be 2 9 8, this is 25 is common, so 3 4 4, so this is 72, and this is 6 into 4 24 into 3 72, so this is the 0. So the required answer is 0, that is difference in 2005 selected participants from Delhi and Mumbai is 0. So E will be the right option. Okay, Now we move on next section. In the next section, second section, directions from 6 to 10 is given as study the following table carefully and answer the questions based on it. The table shows the data about results of students of class 10th who have appeared in board exam from 6 different schools, that is QQRSTNU. Okay, so ye table 6 different schools se total number of result show kar hai, percentage result jo board exam mein appear hue. Okay, so first column shows number of different schools, second column shows percentage of passed, third column shows ratio of male female passed jo ki pass hue, aur fourth column shows ratio of female and male jo ki fail hue. Okay, now we will see the questions. In the question number 6, if the ratio of failed male students of Q to passed male students of S is 1:4, while sum of passed female student of S and failed female students of Q is 160, then find the number of appearing student in Q. So here number of appearing students we asked in school Q. Okay, here ratio of failed male student of Q to passed male student is given S is 1:4. So here and sum of passed female student of S and failed female student of Q is 160. This is Q, percentage is 80, and ratio of male female who passed. So this will be, let total students appeared in school S and Q are X and Y. Total students appeared in school Q, S and Q are X and Y respectively. Okay, so here ratio of failed male student of Q to passed male student of S. So failed male students of Q, this is 4:5, female is to male, so 5/9 into percentage of fail students will be 20%, so 20/100 into Y. Okay, this is in Q, and in S passed male student, so in S passed male student 64% are passed, and passed male students is 5/9, so this is 5/9. This is 64/100 into X, this is given as 1/4. From here 5/9 cancel, 100 cancel, this is 20y/64x is equal to 1/4, this is 1/6, so value of X will be 5/4y. Okay, so this is equation 1. Now sum of passed male female students of S and female failed female students of Q is 160. So here it can be written as x/y is equal to 5/4. So the relation between X and Y is 5:4. Now sum of passed female students of S and failed female students of Q is 160. So sum of passed student of S, so this is S passed students, past female students. So past female student, 4 by 9. So require this will be 4 by 9 into percentage of past students is 64 into this is total students in X. In S is X and plus sum of fail female students of Q. So this is Q and female fail students are 20% and ratio is 4:5. So this is 4 by 9 into 20 100 into Y. This is equal to 160. Okay. So this will be 4 by 9. 4 by 9 and 100 will common. So this is 4 by 900. 64x plus 20y is equal to 160. Okay, so here two equations are there, equation 1 and equation 2. Solving question 1 and 2, this is 10. So 64x plus 20y, this is equal to 9000. Okay, so this is equation 2. From equation 1 and 2 we can find the value of x and y. So solving 1 and 2, equation 1 and 2, number of appearing students in Q, that is we have to find value of y. So if we solve these two equations, x will be equal to 450 and y will be equal to 360. Okay, so this is the answer 360, and if you look at option C will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 7. In the 7th question, if past students of Q are 700 upon 9% more than failed students of S, then by what percent past female students of Q are more than past male students of S. Okay, so here past students of Q are 7009%, 700 upon 9% more than failed students of S. Okay, again let total appeared students in S, X and in Q, Y. Okay, so past students in Q, we can say according to first condition, past students of Q. So this is Q. So past students are 80%, 80 upon 100 into Y. This is equal to 700 upon 9. So 700 upon 9 can be written as 7 by 9. Okay, in fraction, this can be written as 7 upon 9. So this will be 1 plus 7 by 9, that is 16 upon 9, and this is equal to failed students of S. So failed students of S are 36%, 36 into X. So from here if you solve this, 100 and cancel, this is 4 and this is 5. So this is 5y is equal to 4x. Again y is equal to 4y 5x. This is equation 1. And by what percent past female students of Q are more than past male students of S? So this is the relation between x and y. From here we can see y, let y is equal to 4a and x is equal to 5a. Okay, So past female students, past female students from Q, this will be past female student, that is 5 by 12. Past female students has 7 by 12, the ratio is male to female, so 7 by 12 into 80 100 into in Q, this is 4A, so 4A, this will be if we solve this, this will be 0 0 cancel, this is 3, okay. So this will be 7 into 8, this will be 56A divided by 3, 0, okay. This is first quantity, and the second, past male students of S. So past male students of S, this will be S means 5A, so this is 5 by 9, 64 by 100 into 5A. If you solve this, this will be 5 into 5, 25, so this is 4, this is 16, so this is 16A/9. Okay, this is second quantity. Now the required percentage will be R more than past male students of S. So this is here it can be written as 28A/15. Okay, so this is 28A/15 minus 16A/9 divided by 16A/9 into 100. So here A is common, this is cancelled. LCM of 15 and 9 will be 45. So this will be 3 into 28. So 3 into 28 is 84. So this is 84, and this is 16 into 5, that is 80 divided by 16 into 5. Okay. Into 100, so from here this will be 4 by 16, and this is 20, so from here this will be 5%, because 20 into 4 80 divided by 16, that is 5%. So if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 8. So in the 8th question, if failed male students of school Q and failed female students of school U are same in number, then find past male students of Q or what percent of failed male students of U. Here again, is DI mein har question mein, is initially we will assume total number of appearing students. Okay, so let appearing students, appearing students in Q and U, Q in X and U Y. Okay, so failed male students of school Q, failed male students 20%, because 20% are passed, so failed ratio of female and male who are failed 4:5. So for Q, this is failed male students, so this is 5 by 9 into 20/100 into X, this is equal to failed female students of school U, so this is school U, 30% are failed, and failed female students of school U, so this is 4 by 9, so this is 4 by 9 30 upon 100, okay, into y. Here 100 cancel, 99 cancel, this is 00 cancel, so this is 10x, this is 12y, or 5x is equal to 6y. This is equation 1, and or we can say here x upon y is equal to 6y5. This imply x is equal to 6a and y is equal to 5a. Okay, so find past male students of Q are what percent of failed male students of U. So past is male students of Q, or we can say required percentage, this is ratio is 5:7, so 5/12 into 80 upon 100 into 6a divided by failed male students of U. So this is 5/9, 30 upon 100 into 5a into 100. Okay, so here 5 cancel, 100 cancel, 00 cancel, so this is a cancel, this is 8 into 6 into 9 divided by 12 into 3 into 5 into 100. Okay, so here this will be 2, this is 3, and this is 4, so this will be 12 into 100 upon 5, so this is 20, so this is 240%. Okay, so 240% will be the right answer, and if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 9. In the 9th question, it is known that number of appearing students of T is 350, which is 66 into 2 by 3% more than the number of past students of U. Find by what percent failed male of U are more than failed females of T. Again, appeared students in T X in U Y. So appearing students of T is 350. So here this is 350, which is 66 into 2 by 3% more than the number of past students of U. So 66 into 2 by 3 can be written as 2/3. So this is 66 into 2/3% more than y. So we can see that y will be equal to 3/5, okay, of 350. So here this is 70. So 7 into 3, 210. This is the total appearing students in school U. Then find by what percent failed males of U are more than failed females of T. So here failed males of U, so failed males, failed males of U is 5/9 into 30% of 210. This is cancel, this is 3, this is 7, So 7 into 5, that is 35. And failed is females of D. So failed females of T. This is T. Total appearing students in T are 350. And past percentage 72. So failed percentage will be 28%. And ratio is 5:9. So this is 5/14 into 28%, and that is 28/100 into total appearing student 350. So this will be 200, and 5 into 2 10, so 10 cancel, so this will be 35. Here in question, this is 350 is 66 into 2/3% more than the number of past students of you. Sorry by mistake. We have assumed total students. So this is past students of you. Okay. So total students of U will be, this is 70%, so this is 210 into 100 upon 70, this will be 300. Okay. Now failed males of U, this will be 300. Okay. So here this is 5/9, this, so this is 100 cancel. 1 minute, this can be written as 5/9 30 100 into 300, so this is 00 cancel, this is 3 into 3 9, so 9 cancel, so this will be 50. Okay. And failed females of T, so failed females of T is 35. Now required percentage will be 50 minus 35 divided by 35 into 100. So this is 1500/35. So this is 300. And this is 7, so 300/7, or this can be written as 4 to 6/7%. Okay, so this is the required answer, and if you look at options, T will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 10th. In the 10th question, past students of R are what percent of past students of U? Appeared students of R are 8.4 times failed males of U. So failed males of U, here let total appeared students of U is Y. Okay, so failed students of U failed male students of U, this is U, ratio of failed male and female is 5:4, so this is 5/9 into 30 into Y, and this is equal to 1/8.4 of appeared students. So This is equal to 1 upon 8.4 of appeared instruments in R. So this is R. Okay. So appeared instruments in R will be (5/9)(30/100)(8.4)y. So this is 5 × 3 × 8.4 / 900y. Okay. So here this is 300, and here 3 is also common. So this is 100 and this is 28. So this will be 5 × 28. So 5 × 8 is 40, remainder 4, and 5 × 2 is 10, and 4 × 1 = 4/100y, or we can say 1.4y. Okay. So appeared instruments in R is 1.4 times appeared instruments in school U. So past students in R are what percent past students of U? So the required percentage will be, this is R, 75%, this is 1.4y, okay, and past students of U, that is 70% of y into 100. So this is 75 × 1.4 / 70 × 100, or we can say this is 0, so this is 500. Okay, so 00 cancel, so this will be 15%. So this is the 15% This is 75/100 × 1.4, right? Divided by 70/100 × y. Okay. So 100 cancels. 75 × 1.4 × 100 / 70. Okay. So 1 minute. So here this will be 75 × 14 × 10. Okay. And this is 70. So 70. Okay. Okay. So this is 0. Just cancel. Sorry. This will be 150%. Okay. There was calculation mistake. This is 150%. Okay. The right option will be D. Now we move on next question. Our next section. Third section. In the third section, directions from 11 to 15 is given as table given below shows the number of students in same institute over different years. Study the following table carefully and answer the questions given below it. Okay. So this is the table. This is strength, number of students of same institute over the years. These are the students A to G, and this is the different years from 2002 to 2008. Okay. So question 11 is, in year 2005, ratio of male to female students from both institute A and G was same, that is 7:3. What will be the new percentage of females in institute G if 50% of the females and 50% of the male from institute A were transferred to institute G? So ratio of male to female students from both institute A and G was same, that is 7:3. Male in 2000, male students male of A and female of G. This is 7/3. Okay. Number of female students in institute, female students in A, A this is 750, so 3/10 into 8/20, so this is 8/0. So this is, this will be equal to 3 × 8/2, that is 2 × 4 = 6. Okay, and the number of male students in institute A, so number of male students in A, this will be total are 820, or you can say 7/10 into 8/0. This will be 7 × 2 will be 14, so 4 remainder 1, 7 × 8 = 56, 56 × 1 = 57, so 574. Number of male students in G, similarly here ratio of male to female students from both institute A and G was same, 7:3, that is male and female ka ratio A or G mein dono mein 7:3, 7:3. Okay, so is ratio ke vich karke humne number of males and number of, sorry, this is not, okay, in A, here male female in A 7:3 and male female in G 7:3. Okay, so number of male students in G, this is 7/10 in G, this is 750, 7 × 5 = 35, 7 × 7 = 49, and 3 = 52, so this is 5/5, and females in G 3/10 into 750, so this is 3 × 5 = 15, 3 × 7 = 21, 21 + 1 = 22, so 2 × 5. Now new percentage of females in G, here new percentage of females in G, because 50% of 50% of the females and 50% of the males from institute A were transferred to institute G, so new percentage of females in G will be 2 × 5 plus 50% females of A, that is 2 × 4 = 6, so this is 2 × 4 = 6 / 2 = 1 / 2 = 3. Okay, this is total students in G. Total students in G will be 750 plus total students transfers from A to G, so 750 plus, this is divided by 2, so this is 1 / 2 = 3, plus this is divided 574 divided by 2 will be 2, and 8 and 7, so 2 × 8 = 7, so this is 2 × 7 into 100. From here if we solve this, this will be 3 4 8 divided by 750 plus 123 plus 287. So 750 plus 123 plus 287. This is 0. This is 82. 10, 5, 15 and 1, 16. This is 7, 3, 10 and 1, 11. So 1160 into 100. If we solve this, this will be 30%. Okay. So the right option will be A, that is 30%. Okay, next question. Question number 12. In the 12th question, if in 2008 overall 60% students passed from all the institutes, then number of passed students in 2008 is what percent of average number of students from all the institutes in 2006 approximately. Okay, we have to find the value approximate. So here in 2008 overall 60% student passed from all the institutes. This is 2008. Total students in all institute is summation of these all. So this is, or we can say directly, required percentage. This is passed students in 2008. What percent of average number of all students from all the institutes in 2006? So this is 60 of 100 because 60% were passed. Total students in 2008, 780 plus 700 plus 660 plus 840 plus 720 plus 660 plus 740. Okay. This is divided by 1 by 7 in 2006. 740 plus 760 plus 690 plus 790 plus 780 plus 650 plus 680 into 100. Okay, now if you solve this, if you simplify this, this will be 3060 divided by 5090 into 7 into 100. Okay. So if we solve this, this will be 306 into 700 divided by 509. Or we can say that this will be approximately equal to 421%. Okay, so 421% will be the right answer, and if you look at options, B will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 13th. In the 13th question, question number 13th, in year 2003, the ratio of passed students to failed students from Institute C was 4:5. If the number of male and female students for the same institute in year 2003 was 11:7, then find the ratio of students failed to number of females in Institute C in 2003. So here ratio of passed students to failed students from Institute C was 4:5 in 2003. So this is 2003 and this is total students 720. So passed students from C, this will be 4/9 into total students 720. So this is 320, and failed held issuance from C will be total issuance 720 minus past issuance 320, that is 400. Okay. And if number of male and female issuance for the same institute in the year 2003 was 11:7. Okay. So here male students will be 11/18 into 720, that is 440, and female students will be 720 minus 440, that is 0, 12 minus 4, 8, and 6 minus 4, 2. So 280. This is the female students. Now find the ratio of students failed to the number of females in issue C. So ratio of students failed, so failed students are 400 and females in issue C is 280. So the required ratio will be 400 divided by 280, or we can say 40 upon 28. So this is 10/7. 4 is common, so 10/7 will be the right answer. And if you look at option C, will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 14. In the 14th question, if in 2007 20% of students from Institute D and 40% of students from Institute E were selected for an inter-college competition, then what percent of the students from both the college were selected for the competition approximately? So 20% students from Institute D and 40% of students from E. So here required percentage will be 20% from D, so this is D, 2007, 20%, that this is 810, and 40% from E, so this is E, so this is 730. So 20% means 20/100 into 810 plus 40% means 40/100 into 730 divided by total students in both college. So 810 730 04 8715, so this is 1540 into 100. So this will be 81 into 2, this is 162, plus this is 7 3 into 4, so 4 into 3 12, remainder 4 into 7 28, and 129 divided by 1540 into 100. Okay, so this is 224 and 9615, and this is 213 and 14. Okay, into 100 divided by 1540. Okay, if you solve this. If you solve this, this will be equal to approximately 29%. Okay, this is approximately equal to 29% because 45 is the 3 times of 15. So this is approximate value 29%. And if you look at options, D will be the right option. Okay, next question, question number 15th. In the 15th question, the average number of students in Institute F over all the years is what percent more or less than the average number of students in year 2000 for all the institutes approximately? So average number of students in Institute F, so this is F and this is total number of students in Institute F, and total number of average number of students in year 2008. So this is 2008, so this is the total number of students in 2008 from all the institutes. Now average students in F, okay, this will be 1 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, that is 1 by 7 into 620 plus 580 plus 640 plus 560 plus 650 plus 630 plus 660. If you solve this, this will be 1 by 7 into 4340. This will be 620. Okay. Again, average students in 2008 from all institutes. So this is 1 by 7, 780 plus 700 plus 660 plus 840 plus 720 plus 660 plus 740. If you solve this, this will be 51,007. Okay, so the required percentage will be required percentage 51,007 minus 4340/7 divided by 51,007 into 100. Okay, this will be equal to, if you solve this, this will be 760/5100 into 100. Okay, and if you simplify this, this will be 760/51%, or we can write this 15%. Approximately this will be equal to 15%. So if you look at options, C will be the right option. Okay friends, so this is the end of this quantitative aptitude quiz, which were based on tabular DI. Okay, I hope aap log pasand aaya hoga. Thank you so much for listening me, and best of luck for your exams.
Good afternoon everyone, welcome to BANKERSADDA. Today is day 26 of Kar IBPS 2019 FATEH. Aaj ki file machine input output based hai. Directions 1 to 5. Study the following information to answer the given questions. A word and number arrangement machine, when given an input line of words and numbers, rearranges them following a particular rule. तो देखते हैं क्या है. अगर पहला स्टेप देखें तो सबसे जो स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर है जो दैट इज 21, वो लेफ्ट एंड पे अरेंज हुआ है, और उसके जो सेकंड स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर है 32, वो राइट एंड पे अरेंज हुआ है. स्टेप थ्री देखें तो थर्ड लोएस्ट नंबर हमारा 46 लेफ्ट एंड पे, देन फोर्थ लोएस्ट नंबर 65 हमारा राइट एंड पे. तो सारे नंबर्स जो हैं, अगर हम नंबर्स का देखें, numbers are arranged in odd steps in increasing order. From both the sides, अब अगर words को देखें तो words भी हमारे ऐसे ही arrange हुए हैं alphabetical order में in even number steps. तो words हमारे even number step में arrange हुए हैं, again in alphabetical order. From both the ends. तो चलते हैं इनपुट की तरफ. इनपुट हमें दिया गया है पाउंड 18 अंडर 76, ईट 27, ब्राउन 37, 51, विक्ट्री 86 एंड नाइट. तो पहले स्टेप में जो सबसे स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर होगा, लोएस्ट नंबर, दैट इज 18, वो अरेंज होगा. और जो सेकंड स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर है दैट इज 27, वो राइट एंड पे अरेंज होगा. बाकी सारे वर्ड्स एज इट इज अरेंज होंगे. अब स्टेप टू में हमारे वर्ड अरेंज होगा. तो पहले सबसे पहले लेफ्ट एंड पे अरेंज होगा ब्राउन और राइट एंड पे अरेंज होगा ऑब्वियसली ईट. बाकी सारे वर्ड्स हमारे एज इट इज रहेंगे. थर्टी सेवन, फिफ्टी वन, विक्ट्री, 86, नाइट, 27 एंड ईट. स्टेप थ्री में थर्ड लोएस्ट नंबर दैट इज 37 अरेंज होगा और 51 अरेंज होगा. 37 हमारे लेफ्ट मोस्ट एंड पे होगा. स्टेप फोर वर्ड अरेंज होगा, जहां पे लेफ्ट मोस्ट एंड पे होगा नाइट अरेंज और राइट मोस्ट एंड पे होगा पाउंड अरेंज. सो नाइट, 37, ब्राउन, 18, अंडर, 76, विक्ट्री, 86, 27, ईट, 51, पाउंड. स्टेप फाइव में हमारा नंबर अरेंज होगा दैट इज 76 और राइट मोस्ट एंड पे 86 अरेंज होगा. और लास्ट स्टेप है हमारा जिसमें अंडर और विक्ट्री अरेंज होगा. अंडर जो है लेफ्ट मोस्ट एंड पे और विक्ट्री हमारा राइट मोस्ट एंड पे. तो अंडर 76, थर्टी सेवन, ब्राउन, 18, 27, ईट, 51, पाउंड, 86 एंड विक्ट्री. तो ये हमारा फाइनल स्टेप है. चलते हैं क्वेश्चंस की तरफ. क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, हाउ मेनी स्टेप्स वुड बी नीडेड टू कंप्लीट द अरेंजमेंट. क्लियरली 6 स्टेप्स नीडेड थे, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर हुआ. क्वेश्चन नंबर टू, what will be the addition of the numbers 3rd from the left end in step 3, that is 27, and sorry left end say that is 18, and 5th from the right end in step 4, that is 86. तो क्लियरली 104 होगा, इसलिए ऑप्शन सी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर थ्री, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वुड बी द डिफरेंस ऑफ द नंबर विच इज 2nd फ्रॉम लेफ्ट एंड इन स्टेप 4, that is 37, and second from right end in step 2, that is 27. So clearly difference jo hai wo 10 hai, isliye option D hamara correct answer hai. Question number 4. Which of the following element will be fourth from the left end in step 5? Step 5 dekhen. So fourth from the left end jo hoga wo hoga brown. Isliye option B hamara correct answer hua. Question number 5. In step 4, which of the following word or number would be on fourth position from the left? So clearly 18 hai. Isliye option B hamara correct answer hua. Direction 6 to 10. Now, yahan bhi word aur number dono hai. To agar numbers dekhen, to hum dekh sakte hain ki increasing aur decreasing order mein nahi lage hain. Kuch aur logic hoga. Idhar jo sum of the digits hai, उसके अकॉर्डिंग हमारे नंबर्स अरेंज हुए हैं और इंक्रीजिंग ऑर्डर में. जैसे 5 प्लस 4 इज 9, 6 प्लस 1 इज 7, 7 प्लस 1 इज 8, 4 प्लस 1 इज 5 एंड 2 प्लस 4 इज 6. तो क्लियरली सबसे पहले 41 अरेंज हुआ है, नेक्स्ट स्टेप में 24 अरेंज हुआ है, देन 61, 71 एंड लास्ट में 54. तो नंबर्स का अरेंजमेंट इस तरह हुआ है और लेफ्ट मोस्ट एंड पे हुआ है. अब अगर वर्ड्स का देखें, देन वर्ड्स हमारे अगर देखें तो अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर में नहीं हुए, राइट मोस्ट एंड पे हुए हैं, लेकिन अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर में नहीं है. लेकिन अगर उन वर्ड्स के लास्ट लेटर्स को देखें, D, E, O, P and T, तो ये alphabetical order में arrange हुए हैं. तो words are arranged at the rightmost end according to the last letter of the word और alphabetical order में. तो ये लॉजिक यूज हुआ है हमारे इस मशीन इनपुट आउटपुट में. इनपुट की तरफ चलते हैं. स्टेप 1, पहले नंबर्स ऐड कर लेते हैं. 8 प्लस 1 अगेन 9, 7 प्लस 1 8, 5 प्लस 1 6, 4 प्लस 1 इज 5 एंड 2 प्लस 5 इज 6, सॉरी 7. तो नंबर्स में सबसे पहले 41 अरेंज होगा, ऑल्सो एक और चीज ये है कि नंबर्स और वर्ड्स दोनों साइमल्टेनियसली अरेंज हुए हैं एक ही स्टेप में. अरेंज हुए हैं हर स्टेप में. तो नंबर्स का हमने सम देख लिया है और अगर वर्ड्स का देखें तो N तो बीन पहले आएगा, फिर नो होगा, फिर R होगा, फिर हैज होगा और फिर इंटरेस्ट होगा. तो चलिए इनपुट करते हैं. स्टेप 1, सबसे पहले होगा 41 लेफ्ट मोस्ट एंड पे और बीन होगा राइट मोस्ट एंड पे. बाकी सारे वर्ड्स हमारे ऐसे ही अरेंज होंगे. स्टेप 2, फिर अरेंज होगा 51 41 आर 18 हैज 71 इंटरेस्ट, 25 बीन एंड देन नो. स्टेप थ्री देखें. स्टेप थ्री में 41, 51 के बाद अरेंज होगा 25. तो 25, 51, 41 और आर अरेंज होगा राइट मोस्ट एंड पे. स्टेप फोर में 71 अरेंज होगा, 18, 71, 25, 51, 41, 9, R, and interest. तो ये फाइनल हमारा स्टेप है. चलते हैं क्वेश्चंस की तरफ. क्वेश्चन नंबर वन. इन विच स्टेप द एलिमेंट 71 इंटरेस्ट बीन आर फाउंड इन द सेम ऑर्डर. तो अगर क्लियरली हम देखें तो थर्ड स्टेप में है, इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन नंबर सेवन. विच एलिमेंट इज एग्जैक्टली बिटवीन 41 एंड इंटरेस्ट इन स्टेप फोर. 41 एंड इंटरेस्ट क्लियरली 18 है, इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. क्वेश्चन एट. इन स्टेप टू विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एलिमेंट वुड बी द सेकेंड टू द राइट ऑफ द फोर्थ फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट पोजिशन. तो अगर फोर्थ फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट है एंड सेकेंड टू द राइट है, तो क्लियरली सिक्स्थ फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट है. जो कि क्लियरली 71 है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है. हाउ मेनी स्टेप्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू कंप्लीट द अबव अरेंजमेंट. क्लियरली 5 स्टेप्स रिक्वायर्ड है, इसलिए क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 का आंसर होगा ऑप्शन बी. क्वेश्चन नंबर 10. Which of the following is step 3 after arrangement? So 25, 51, 41, 18 has 71 interest, bean, no R. इसलिए option A हमारा correct answer हुआ. Directions 11 to 15. ये थोड़ा ट्रिकी इनपुट आउटपुट है. यहां पे पहले नंबर्स देखते हैं. नंबर्स देखें तो सबसे स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर दैट इज 26 अरेंज हुआ है, लेकिन उसके बाद सबसे हाईएस्ट नंबर 87 अरेंज हुआ है. फिर सेकंड लोएस्ट नंबर 48 अरेंज हुआ है, देन सेकंड हाईएस्ट नंबर 78 अरेंज हुआ है. वैसे ही थर्ड लोएस्ट नंबर 49 अरेंज हुआ है एंड देन 58 अरेंज हुआ है. तो जो नंबर्स हैं वो अल्टरनेटिवली हमारा हाईएस्ट पहले लोएस्ट नंबर अरेंज हुआ है, देन हमारा हाईएस्ट नंबर अरेंज हुआ है. लेफ्ट मोस्ट एंड पे अरेंजिंग हुई है, अब अगर वर्ड्स देखें तो क्लियरली वर्ड्स जो है वो सिंपली अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर में रेंज हुए हैं, फ्लाई, मैन, प्रॉब्लम, सॉल्व, टाइम एंड व्हाट। तो क्लियरली वर्ड्स तो जो है क्लियरली अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर में रेंज हुए हैं। राइट एंड से, यहाँ राइट एंड से अरेंजमेंट हुई है और वो नंबर्स की भी राइट लेफ्ट एंड से अरेंजमेंट हुई है, लेफ्ट मोस्ट एंड पे नहीं हुई है, ना ही राइट मोस्ट एंड पे हुई है। चलते हैं इनपुट की तरफ। स्टेप वन, सबसे स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर जो है 16 वो अरेंज होगा और जो अल्फाबेटिकल ऑर्डर में फर्स्ट आएगा दैट इज बॉय, वो अरेंज होगा फर्स्ट स्टेप में, बाकी सारे एलिमेंट्स ऐसे ही रहेंगे। वायलेट, ऑरेंज, 91, 32, स्मॉल, 67, 51, यू एंड बॉय। स्टेप टू देखें तो हाईएस्ट नंबर जो है 91 वो अरेंज होगा और अल्फाबेटिकली हमारा नॉट अरेंज होगा। स्टेप थ्री में सेकेंड स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर दैट इज 29 अरेंज होगा एंड देन ऑरेंज अरेंज होगा राइट मोस्ट एंड से। स्टेप फोर में जो सेकेंड हाईएस्ट नंबर है 67 वो अरेंज होगा एंड देन स्मॉल अरेंज होगा। स्टेप फाइव में जो थर्ड लोएस्ट नंबर है दैट इज 32 वो अरेंज होगा स्टेप सिक्स 58 अरेंज होगा अब और वाई हमारा सॉरी वायलेट हमारा राइट मोस्ट एंड से अरेंज होगा। स्टेप सेवन, फोर्टी सेवन अरेंज होगा वाई हमारा यहां अरेंज होगा तो ऑटोमेटिकली 51 अरेंज हो जाएगा और यू भी हमारा ऑटोमेटिकली अरेंज हो जाएगा तो 51 और यू के लिए अलग स्टेप नहीं होगा। ये हमारा फाइनल स्टेप है। चलते हैं क्वेश्चंस की तरफ। क्वेश्चन 11, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वुड बी द फाइनल अरेंजमेंट। तो अगर फाइनल अरेंजमेंट में अगर ऑप्शन वाइज देखें तो क्लियरली वर्ड्स और नंबर्स हमारे अरेंज नहीं है, यहाँ पे भी नहीं है, इस स्टेप में भी नहीं है, और अगर लास्ट स्टेप में देखें तो हमारे सारे अरेंज्ड हैं करेक्ट ऑर्डर में, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है। क्वेश्चन 12, इन स्टेप 3 विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एलिमेंट वुड बी एट सिक्स पोजिशन फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट। तो सिक्स पोजिशन फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट अगर देखें तो क्लियरली है टॉल, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है। क्वेश्चन 13, इन स्टेप 5 विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग वर्ड्स वुड बी एट सिक्स पोजिशन पोजिशन टू द राइट ऑफ 8th फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट एलिमेंट। सो 8th फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट एंड 6th पोजिशन टू द राइट, तो क्लियरली 14th फ्रॉम द राइट लेफ्ट हुआ, 14th फ्रॉम लेफ्ट। तो अगर स्टेप 5 में देखें तो क्लियरली ऑरेंज है, इसलिए ऑप्शन बी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर हुआ। क्वेश्चन नंबर 14, इन स्टेप 4 ऑफ द रीअरेंजमेंट If 16 is related to 29, अगर फोर्थ स्टेप में देखें 16 is related to 29, 67 is related to 47 in a certain way, which of the following would 58 be related to? So 58 will be related to clearly 32, इसलिए ऑप्शन ए हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है। क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज लास्ट बट वन स्टेप। तो क्लियरली सिक्स्थ है, इसलिए ऑप्शन डी हमारा करेक्ट आंसर है।